humidity. So this is going to be a real challenge for this young English team against the Spanish team that really are growing. I'm excited by their prospect.
Yeah, they had a good tournament in Sevilla, yet to reach a cup quarterfinal this season. They've been in a training camp with Ireland and France ahead of this tournament. And it's England, left to right, in white, who get us underway in Pool B. That's gone over the sideline, so it'll be an attacking line-out for England. Freddie Roddick, one of the key men for this England team. Bit like
inside piece directly.
Former England Sevens player Dan Bibby in that playmaker role. And yeah, they balk on the line-out to England, so good work from Spain to put off the England line-out set piece there.
It's going to be really tough for the English defence if they do keep giving the Spanish the ball, because one thing they're really good at is keeping hold of it. They've got an offloading game that's threatening now as well.
Nico Nieto. Manu Sainz-Trapanga alongside his brother, Toby, in this starting seven lineup. There's Pol Pla, key man arriving, and this guy, Toby Sainz-Trapanga, has the offloading game that might well open the door. Juan Ramos now. Back to Sainz. Here's Pol Pla. Bit of footwork from Manu Sainz. Through the hands of Javier Duan, on-field co-captain Ramos. Good structure play so far from the Spanish team. Nieto, inside ball to Manu Sainz. That's gone back on the England side, though. Here's Jamie Bardon. Freddie Roddick across to the not small figure of Jamie Adamson out of Durham University, also played for the Samurai Sevens on many an invitational on the circuit. Nieto with the tackle. Joe Browning plays scrum half for England. There's the offload that might open the door from Roddick, and it will. And it's Jamie Adamson who will score his second all-time try for England on the HSBC World Rugby 7 Series.
And it's a nice combination by the Invitational graduates on the left. Roddick gets the ball in his hand, and it's an offload out the back. Really good, because it brings in two defenders, keeps that arm free, and then the striding Adamson, who has been doing amazing things with Durham University on the book series, which is, again, the pathway that England choose to really look at bringing players through on. He's kept that form going. That was really good from England, because they held out the Spanish team, who kept the ball for 2 minutes there.
Yeah, played for England on the Rugby Europe Grand Prix Series before making his Sevens debut in Spain back in January. And look at that. All England so far. Remember, they got the ball right from the kickoff with the line-out. Malfunction at the line-out, but they have the first score of the game. It's been converted as Roddick gets us back underway. Look at Bowen, not the biggest figure in the world, and he can't get as high as Manuel Sainz. Browning trying to hold him up, but he gets his knees to the floor, so he has to let go. Pol Pla gets the ball away from the breakdown. Javier Duan. Nieto. Toby Sainz-Trapanga back to Pol Pla. Javier Duan again looks to get the levers clear, and he does. He finds Pol Pla with the inside ball. And that's a fine response from Spain. The conversion will be the levelling score.
You know, when tactics pay off and how a team want to play, because there's just as much celebration to the offload creator than there is Pol Pla who supports it. Javier Duan, number three for Spanish, gets back up. And three players engulf him. This is exactly what they've spoken about doing. Homer tries to make the tackle. He goes high, gets the fend right in the gut. And then Pol Pla, as he always does, beyond the shoulder of these big men in the middle. And you don't need to invite him many times. He'll find the line.
Ramos with the conversion. Pol Pla with his 63rd career try. He was the first ever Spaniard to score 50 in series history. That was back in Vancouver 2020, but they've malfunctioned off the restart. So Spain's up. Bowen can get us restarted, and he chips ahead. And this might well work out for England. And they do have the score. It is Freddie Roddick on the chase. Hello, Freddie. You've got to score for England.
Well, he's going to keep waving in celebrations if he keeps this thinking up. Bowen takes the tap. Conversation on the inside. You can see Roddick saying no on there in behind. But how about the pace? Really picks up. You mentioned the reference to Dan Bibby, which is some compliment. But the fact it bounces just a foot yard short of the line, that's a really difficult pickup. He then manages to get it down. That's how you please your coach.
Yeah, spoke to Tony Roakes, the England head coach, during the week, and he just couldn't be more effusive about Tom Bowen and the influence he's having on this young team. There is Tony Roakes in shot. Just the leadership, the character, the energy, just the good vibrations that Tom Bowen brings to this team.
Yeah, and we see a lot on the field, but a lot of sevens is won off the pitch. How you maintain those levels of energy, enthusiasm, of tactics, leadership, everything you see on the pitch. This is like 3% of their week. It's about making sure you've got good squad people.
Paul Blatt, try to score it. Sets up a breakdown on the far side. Coming at pace was Sane Strapanger, and they might have found an opening over here on the near side. Juan Ramos again, and the big figure of Javier Duan into contact. Spain responded well after England's first score. Can they do it again? Manu Sane Strapanger, good chop tackle backwards on him. Pol Pla works really well for Spain to maintain possession there. Little skip clear from Ramos. Good feet. Look at him go. The double jump step. Pol Pla, he's got support. It's Juan Ramos. Couple of players to beat. He might need help. Browning does well for England. They get the penalty, Spain. And they will, of course, go quickly, and they will score. That was well played. Good keep ball. Juan Ramos finishes it off.
Dan Norton in the ear of the referee there, trying to ask the question why the penalty was given. Said it wasn't a clear release, which meant the Spanish could react faster that close to the try line. One collision is going to get you over. But again, showing how well this Spanish team are going. When they get it, they've got such probing players. The Sane Strapanger brothers are really pivotal to their play.
Important conversion this to level the scores, and it gets there. Excellent play from Juan Ramos and Spain. They have leveled this up 14 all at the break in Pool B. Great to see him back though, isn't it? New Zealand, Fiji, Samoa, all returning to the series here in Singapore. Juan Ramos. Good for Spain in that first half, and great to see Dan Norton back on the series for England. His first appearance in Elite Seven since the Tokyo Olympic Games. Can he add to his all-time leading try scoring tally in this Pool B opener against Spain? Confidence put in him, of course, from Tony Roakes, head coach. Straight off the bat to start for England, and why not? One of the greatest of all time. Penalty Spain, though. At the breakdown, taking it into contact was Will Homer, but really good work from Nico Nieto. Here's Ramos again. He's been excellent. Manu Sainz. Good chop tackle from Tom Bowen. Pol Pla, he picks up a score in the first half. Change of direction from Spain. They like to do this. Ask questions of the defense. Ramos. Nieto back to Ramos, sporting that Burt Reynolds moustache. He's a star of the Sevens team for Spain, that's for sure. There he is again at scrum half, Pol Pla. He's got Sane Strapanger to his left. Pol Pla, Ramos, just playing really good keep ball here, Spain. Being very patient, and the patience is undone by the error. It was all going so well for them.
Wasn't it just talking of how the Spanish like to play the game is underpinned by their lack of errors. We've just seen two in this game from them. Norton absolutely in no man's land there. Manu Sane Strapanger, he was walking in on that left-hand side if that pass were a little bit more accurate. But this is going to be both encouraging for the Spanish, sitting in ninth on the HSBC 7 series. Slightly concerning
for the English, just at how well the Spanish are keeping the ball against them. That makes defensively a very different proposition.
Yeah, England won 4 of their 5 matches against Spain on the 2020 series.
Thank you. Mark is here.
This is the 26th meeting between these two sides.
Left of the mark.
First time they've ever played here.
Crouch.
England.
2 victories for Spain against
set.
England on the Sevens World Series. All tied up here.
Out by the tunnel.
Something's got to give. Plenty of time to go. 5 minutes to go in the second half. We'll have a reset.
Yeah, we've seen a couple of really heavily contested scrums this tournament so far. Ex-forward myself.
Crouch.
England.
Former England Sevens captain and hooker, Rob Vickerman. Perhaps one of the
set.
The most underdeveloped parts of rugby sevens, the scrum. Using it as an opportunity to turn over possession. Opportunity here for Ed Coulson. Bedford Blue out there off the bench for England. They've got the decision. Also an appearance of Api Bavandra as well in the 13 shirt. Good to see him out there. Born in England, but Fijian heritage.
Wonderful combination of all the best England seven teams I've seen. There's usually been a couple of Fijian heritage players in there. You know, Damadamu, Josh Drianui. This guy, he's got high potential, very physical. Typically offloading game, you'd expect that, but really like how he's developing it. Like to see him go well this tournament.
You're good, or you want to sub?
Yeah, Leeds Beckett University.
Okay, let's
made
go.
His debut on the series in Paris back in 2019.
Off,
this
please.
Is his second event. Yes, he went to boarding school in Fiji when he moved back there with Meli Durenalangi and his uncle. He's been the assistant coach of Fiji Sevens, so he comes from a strong Sevens background. There's Api Bavandra, 21 years of age, and Tony Roakes is hoping that he can really add something to this England Sevens team here in Singapore this weekend. They've got the line out. They throw to Adamson, who scored the opening try of this contest, and they've got the penalty, England.
15.
Just slowed a little bit this game. Not a bad thing, as I mentioned, the condition of this England team is very much the start of their journey, and they'll be appreciating the last 60 seconds or so have been quite slow. A few penalties coming in to make that a factor, but then they know they've got this launch play very well coached in their lineout. And
inside
Dan Norton hanging out on the left finally gets his boots on, having been trying to adjust those for a few minutes, but he's certainly someone to utilize.
Turnover at the lineout for Spain, really well done. That's what they need. Get the ball back, make something happen. Eduardo Lopez, now Pol Pla again. So dangerous, look at that dummy. You've got to watch him. Nieto off the deck, flicked on by Ramos. A little high for the diminutive figure of Juan Ramos. Heavy carry into contact from Jojo Ceres for Spain. Been turned over by England. Here's Bavandra. His first opportunity. There's the offload we're talking about. To Freddie Roddick. And Roddick has found a way through for England. Already a try in this game. He finds the support runner. It is Ed Coulson. And Ed Coulson will get the go-ahead score for England. The offload from Bavandra. The wheels from Roddick. And the finish from that man, Ed Coulson.
Yeah, real all-rounder, Ed Coulson. But this is what I like to see. Point of difference in an England team is to have a skill set like this. Api Bavandra gets that ball free. Initial tackle not completed, so Roddick doesn't have to release. He can carry on running from that point, and you can see Coulson hanging around at that point, stays with him, gets the ball, and carries it forward. The Bedford Blues man chalking up a try on the HSBC 7 series.
Conversion doesn't make it, remains a 5-point ball game. We've got 2 minutes to go. Good try from Ed Coulson, ex-Harbury College, Bedford Blues, Newcastle Falcons time Academy originally.
Yeah, a bit of a nomad, a little bit of time in South Africa and Australia. So if you're going to do rugby, see the world.
Freddie Roddick, how good has he been in this game? Bit of a Scottish-Englishman, Musselburgh RFC, East Lothian in Scotland.
Yeah, glad to see him really stepping up. Saw a bit of him on the Invitational Series, thinking he's got elements of a game that could make him stand out, and he's living up to that.
Bavandra on the chase. Oh, he's done brilliantly. Api Bavandra, look at him go. Can he reach out? Just short. That was brilliant. Norton's there to help out. And they shove over the sideline the figure of Manu Moreno.
No, no, no.
Well, how about that off the restart from Roddick and Bavandra?
Again, young players combining really well. Bavandra gets it, marauds down this left-hand side. Thought he was almost going to get there. There's the take, the regather, off he goes. That little fend initially dummied. Then the second one comes out, the tackle completed really well by the Spanish Fijian, Davo Bavari. And again, the line-out's faltering for England.
A knock on from England, so it'll be a scrum to Spain. A minute to go, converted trial, win it for Spain. So it's going to go down to the wire, this one. You see they've had so much possession, Spain, they often do, but they are 5 points behind on the scoreboard.
But that for me is the stat, top left now. They've had 50 carries, just one offload. The offload game for the Spanish team is what's going to be the point of difference. They look to play wit, but their success comes from the big men getting that ball in behind. As we've seen with England, they scored two tries from offloads. That's what the Spanish team need to look for doing, but they don't have the pill.
Yeah, scrum England, and the chip through, cleverly done from Ed Coulson, but that's given possession back to Ramos and Spain. 20 seconds to go. Can they go the distance and at least level this one up for the tying score? Here's Davo Bavai for Spain. Fijian born, wearing Spanish colours. Manu Sainz-Trapanga into contact, ball's clear, maintaining possession again. Shaking off the tackle was Moreno, and that's gone over the sideline, and that'll be that.
The ball was out and he kicked the ball, it's okay.
So Spain just perhaps showing a lack of urgency at the end there, but England won't mind. They will get the win first up in Pool B. England sevens have beaten Spain by 19 points to 14. Well, interesting couple of decisions at the end there. England had possession, kicked the ball away, gave an opportunity.